Let's write a program to find maximum among three positive numbers. So you'll be given a numbers like this, let's say n1, 4, n2 is given let's say 8, and n3 let's say any positive number, 2. So among all these, if you see, n2 is the largest. So you need to write a program which will just produce the output, and then it is going to receive three numbers, three positive numbers, and the output should be the largest among these three numbers. So pause the video and try to write the program for this. Alright, assuming that you have tried writing the program for this, for those who could not solve this program, let's see how can we solve this. So first of all, I'll be taking three numbers n1, n2, n3 whose data type is int, and then I'll be taking the user input. So I'll just say the user to enter n1, and using the cin statement I will take the value of n1. After that, the same thing I'll be doing for n2 and n3 as well. So I'll be writing here n2, and then again the variable name n2. Here I'll say enter n3 and the variable name n3. Alright, so after the user gives the input, we need to find out which is the largest of these three numbers, right? So the question is here that how can we find the largest among these three numbers. So what I can do, I can just take this number n1 and compare against number n2 and n3. If n1 is greater than both n2 as well as n3, then we can just declare that n1 is the largest number. In the similar way, if we compare n2 with n1 and n3, and if n2 comes out to be largest, we can declare n2 is the largest. And in the same way, we can treat for n3. And the last condition would be that the three numbers can be equal, right? So let's see how can we write the code for this. So definitely, since we need to check conditions here, we need to deal with condition here, we are going to use if statements. So I'll be writing here, if n1 is greater than n2, right, then what? Should we declare that n1 is largest? No, we need to check n1 with n3 as well, yes or no? So again I will check here that n1 is greater than n3 as well. Now if you observe here, this n1 greater than n2 is one relational expression, and n1 greater than n3 is another relational expression. Whenever we need to connect two relational or more than two relational expression together, then we use something called logical operators. Now here we want that this result, that is n1 greater than n2, must be true, as well as n1 greater than n3 also must be true. So in this case we will be using the logical AND, right? So you can see here that we are using the relational expression with logical AND. If this condition is true, in that case I will declare that n1 is the largest number, right? So I'll say here n1 is the largest, followed by new line. Alright, then else if, let's say if this first condition is not true, I'll jump to this part, right? That is, I can write here n2 greater than n3. Let me compare n2 with n1. If this is true, and I also need to check that whether n2 is greater than n3 as well. If both of these conditions are true, then I can just put the message here that n2 is the largest. So I can just write here n2 is the largest. Then the next condition, else if. As I've already told you that we can have multiple else if. Now I'll check n3 with n1. If n3 is greater than n1 and n3 is greater than n2 as well, if both the relational expression are true, then I can declare here that now n3 is the largest. Otherwise, what could, now let us say, what will be the last expression? So the last thing is going to be that if none of the condition matches, that means n1, n2, n3 all are equal. So finally, if the above condition doesn't meet, then finally I can say all three numbers are equal. So let's run it and let's see what happens, followed by new line. So let me just save the code and I'll be compiling it now. So I'll just choose my directory, and for compiling I'll just use this command, and my file name is here test.cpp, and I'll just produce the file name as test. Alright, so the compilation is successful. So I'll be using the command to run it, /test, and hit enter. It says enter n1, right? So actually I should be writing here properly this colon so that the program looks little good. Alright, let me just abort the program. Let me clear it out. So I'll run it again. After compiling it, I will just run it again. So it says now enter n1. So I'll enter the value 8 here. After that I will enter, let's say, 3, and here 4. So naturally 8 is the largest, right? This time let's give n2 the largest. N1 let's say 7, n2 81, and let's say n3 9. Alright, so 81 is largest, obviously. Now let us say if we have something like this, let's say 4, then 3, and let's say here 8. So you can see 8 is the largest, that means n3 is the largest. Now let us say that if all three numbers are equal, let's say 4, 4, 4. So in that case, all three numbers are equal, right? So what happened? If you observe here, n1 8 and n2 3 and 4. So n1 is compared, 8 is compared with 3, and then 8 is again compared with 4. Since n1, which is having the value 8, so we get here this condition becomes true, and hence we get 8 as the largest. And in a similar way, these blocks are also working, right? So if you observe here, only one of the if block executes. Let's say if this line number 15, in this the condition fails, we'll jump to this else if part. If let us say this condition fails, then we'll jump to this else if part. Otherwise the last is that if all the three numbers are equal, then we'll come to this else part, right? So that's it for this video. See you in the next video.